Hi students, welcome back to today's class. Now we are going to see the digital documentation lesson, that is unit 3. Under this next topic we are going to move on, that is starting LibreOffice Writer. So how to open LibreOffice Writer software, that we will see now. So in general you will find a shortcut of LibreOffice on the desktop or on the quick launch taskbar. Okay, so like this you will have a shortcut icon on the LibreOffice on your desktop. Okay, on your desktop, like this shortcut icon, no? Now like this small arrow, it will be appearing at the leftmost corner. Okay, so left bottom corner you will be having the shortcut icon, that is like arrow, small arrow will be appearing. So this is only known as shortcut icon. So like this you will have a shortcut icon on your desktop screen, or on the quick launch taskbar you will be having that LibreOffice icon. Okay, so the process may slightly differ according to the operating system. If you are using Windows or Linux, according to that. So here we have, I have used Windows 10. So in this, it will be appearing like that. To start LibreOffice Writer in Windows, double-click LibreOffice Writer shortcut. So I have double-clicked that software. Then I have opened this LibreOffice Writer, untitled one. That is, name is not given. So that initially it will be opened as untitled one here. So like this, after double click on it, the shortcut icon, we will get that LibreOffice Writer software. Okay, that window will get up here. Okay, so to start LibreOffice Writer in Windows, double click LibreOffice Writer shortcut, which is usually found on the computer desktop. Okay, so after opening, it will be looking like this. You need to click on this Writer document here. Okay, if you want to open Writer, you just click on this Writer document. Okay, alternatively, click on the Start Windows button, select LibreOffice, click on Start, okay, and then All Apps here, and then LibreOffice 6.4, and then LibreOffice Base, Draw, Impress, Math, Writer. So like that, some of the components which are available under LibreOffice will be available. So if you click on this, we will open LibreOffice Writer software. So like that also we can follow the procedure. We can click on Start or Windows button, select LibreOffice, and then LibreOffice Writer from the application window. This screen is shown here for a Ubuntu, okay, Ubuntu Linux. So using the search command also, we can type the word Writer in the search field and select LibreOffice Writer from the offered results. See, this is only known as search command. So just click on the search command. Here you need to type the word Writer, okay, so Writer. Immediately it will show whatever Writer softwares I have used in this laptop, that is visible here. So OpenOffice Writer and LibreOffice Writer, two softwares I have here. So in this offered list, you need to choose this LibreOffice Writer that will get opened. So this is another method in order to open the LibreOffice Writer by using the search command. So what are the three methods in order to open the LibreOffice Writer? First one is, you may need to double click on the LibreOffice Writer shortcut, which is usually found on the computer desktop. And then we need to click on the Start Windows button, select LibreOffice and LibreOffice Writer from application window. And then we need to use the search command, type the word Writer in the search field, and we need to select the LibreOffice Writer from the offered results. And in the fourth method, in Ubuntu Linux, find LibreOffice Writer icon on the application launcher. See here in the application launcher, you have this LibreOffice Writer software. Search it by clicking on Show Applications. Okay, and then we need to create the document. So after we open the LibreOffice Writer, we need to create the document. So to create a new document, we need to use the keyboard shortcut, that is Control plus N. We need to click on from the keyboard, or else mouse options, if you go for File, New, Text Document, you need to click. Okay, so create a new text document by using File menu, and then New, and then Text Document. Now save the file by clicking on the File menu, Save. Then that is, give the name of the file, for example, report. By default, the file is going to be saved in which extension? .odt format, OpenOffice, the document text format, okay. So different file formats are also available. Step three, saving the file by another name. So you can save the file by the another name also. It is possible to make another copy of the file by saving it with another name using the Save As option, File, and then Save As. If you click, you can save the same file in the another name also. once the user saves the document by giving a name, it is called a file. So once the document is going to be saved with one file name, name, then that is going to be called as file only. The users can save the file with another name in another location by using the save as option. The user will get the two files for the previous one and the one with the new name. So user is going to get the new files, two files they will get, one when they were saving using file save option, another file name by using save as option, file save as option. So like that, two names, file names they will have for the same document. And if they want to close the document after finishing the work, close the file, as too many open files will cause a disturbance in working. So to close the file, what we need to do, select file and close. File menu again you need to click in order to close this. See, if you want to open, create a new document, file menu, click on file menu, new, and then text document or control plus N also you can do. In order to close, file menu, close. And if you want to open already saved file, you can click on this open. If you want to save, you need to click on control plus yes, or you need to press control plus yes, or save icon you need to use. Or else you can give control plus shift plus yes, or save as. Okay. So like that, we can use many options in order to save, close, and opening, creating a new document. Step 5 is, in order to open the document, it may further require to open a file for editing. So why we want to open a file, existing file? Either for reading purpose or for doing some changes in the existing file, we may open the file. So select file open, that is control plus O, and the document will be open for editing. Next one, to save a document using password. So if you want to save the document using a password, select file save, select the location on the disk to save the file. For example, this untitled one LibreOffice Writer, for an example, I'm going to show you. Click on file and then save option. So now it is save as dialog box got opened. So now you can give a new name for this. Okay, so just we'll give new writer like that. I'm giving one name. And then already default save as type is ODF text format. We can choose some other formats also, like XML ODF format. And then HTML format, rich text, and then Office open XML text format, and then Word 2007 365 unified Office format text. Like it, so many file formats are available. In that, you whichever format you want to save, you can save it. But here, by default, ODF only is the text document format, which is used for the LibreOffice Writer. And then, if you want to save this document with the password. See, this is automatic file name extension. It is already enabled. If you want to enable this save with password, you need to click this checkbox. So it will ask for the password. So you need to enter the password to open, and you need to confirm the password here, and then you need to click on OK. So whenever this document, if you want to open in future, then without giving this password, the file will not get opened. Understood? For this purpose only, we need to save the file with the save with password option. So I'm going to cancel here. I didn't save the file, so just for an explanation, I have used the file save. Okay, so select file save, select the location on the disk to save the file, type a suitable name for the document, and click on save button. To save the document with password, put a tick mark on checkbox, and then save with password. Type the password to open the file in a set password dialog box. Okay, so what we have opened here is set password. When you click file save, save with password, save. So set password dialog box only we have opened here. So the password dialog box only opened here. Set password dialog box here. We need to give the password. Okay. Type the same password in the second box and click OK button if you want to save the document with the password. Next, what are the parts of the writer window which are available here? Okay. So first one is the various parts of the writer window are, first one, title bar. The title bar is located on the top of the writer window. See here, this like title bar will be appearing. That is the top of the writer window. It shows the title of the currently opened document. See here, it is untitled one only. Entitled one, LibreOffice Writer. This is only known as here title bar. And second one is menu bar. And then third one is toolbars. Formatting toolbar, standard toolbar like that. This is known as formatting toolbars, and this is standard toolbars. Okay. And then status bar. Bottom we have the status bar. And here we have zooming, zoom slider, and zooming percentage. All those things are there that we will see one by one. Okay. So title bar is located on the top of the writer window. It shows the title of the currently open document. The name of the document means file name of the document saved on the disk. Whatever file name we have given while saving, that name will be appearing in the title bar. For new document, it shows the title of the document as for untitled X, where X is the document number. So if you opened the writer for the first time, it will be showing like untitled 1. Second time, if you open untitled 2, like that, it will go on. Okay. So this is known as title bar, and then this is menu bar, and the third one is standard toolbar, and fourth one is formatting toolbar, and this is vertical scroll bar, and this is zoom control, and the last one is status bar that I have already shown to you. And now menu bar. Okay, so menu bar, if you click on this file menu, it will be listing some of the sub menus here. Okay, so same way other menus also will work in the same method. So in this sub menu, some of the menus are having commands after we have three dots, and some will have the small arrow here, dark arrow here, okay, right side arrow, and like this some of things are available that we will see here what is the purpose of that every sub menus. Okay, so menu bar, it appears below the title bar. It shows the menu items like file, edit, view, and then insert, format, style, tables, tools, window, and helper. So on selecting a menu item, its submenu will open below the menu item. See, like this submenu will get opened. Okay. And we can select any item in the submenu as per our requirement. And file menu they have opened here. Selecting the file menu shows the submenu as shown in the figure 6.3.6. The submenu item which shows three dots. See here, save remote file, and then print dot dot dot, and then export as PDF dot dot dot, export dot dot dot. Three dots are appearing now after the submenu. That is how that will be opened. So just after the submenu name, it means clicking on it. So when you are clicking on this menu, submenus, it will open the dialog box. And then arrow we have it was placed near to some of the submenus. The purpose of this arrow we will see. It will be having another submenu inside that. The submenu item which shows the right hand side arrows just after the submenu name means clicking on it, it will open the another submenu. Next we have toolbars. The toolbar appears below the menu bar. By default, the standard toolbar and formatting toolbar will appear. So by default, which two toolbars will be appear? Standard toolbar and formatting toolbars will be appearing. The other toolbars can be activated by clicking on view menu. So the other toolbars, if you want to open by clicking on the view menu, we can open the other toolbars, and we can select the toolbars of submenu. The user can choose the required toolbars by clicking on it. For example, the selected toolbar will show the sign, that is the sign before the toolbar. Suppose we select the find toolbar, then the find word in the toolbar will appear as find. Okay, see, for example, let us see, you go to view and then toolbars. See, toolbars, find I have selected. Okay, so that here the find toolbar got opened here. See, this is for find. Okay, this is find box. So find and replace box, control plus H. So this toolbar was opened in order to find it. So the tick mark will be available when this toolbar is got selected. See here, toolbars, the tick mark will be available. I'll show that. I have enabled the find now. So like this, this tick symbol will be available if the toolbar got selected means. Okay. Okay, tick sign before the toolbar. Suppose we select the find toolbar, then the find word in the toolbar. The word was there, no find. That word has the tick symbol before that word. See here, this is having the find word. Before that, we have the tick mark. Okay, so like that, this will get appear. Next is standard toolbar. It contains command in the form of icons. See, standard toolbar is having, it is displayed in the form of icons only. Okay. Next, we have the formatting toolbar. Okay, below that standard toolbar, we have the formatting toolbar. It contains various options for formatting a document. A graphical representation of commands is shown in the form of icons. Next, we have the status bar. So this is only known as status bar. So these two are combined together, called as status bar. So this is positioned at the left bottom of the writer window and displays the number of pages. See here, number of pages, page one of one, and then number of words, and then the language which is going to be used here, which is used here, like English language, and then zooming level. It is located at the bottom of the workspace. Okay, so bottom of the workspace we have our the status bar and the zooming, all those things. Okay, so you can see one by one. First page number we have here, and then word count and character count, 490 characters, and then page type, default style, and languages, you what language it was used here, and then selection mode, document changes status, and then view layout, zoom slider, zoom percentage level. So all those things will be appearing at the status bar. Next is scroll button and scroll bar. It is used to scroll the document, that is move, navigate the document. And zoom, it allows us to change the scale of the text and pictures in the document only for viewing purpose. So if you want to view the text, whether we have done any mistake or the style, font style and all okay or not, if you want to check the quality of the document, okay, we can go for this zoom level. Okay, zoom percentage and zoom slider, we can use it, okay, to change the scale of the text, that is the size of the text and pictures in the document only for viewing. It does not affect the physical document. So zoom will not affect the physical document. It is used to check the finishing quality of the document, to know the meaning of the other tools, position the mouse pointer on the tool and see the tool tip. So other tools meanings, if you want to understand, you need to position the mouse pointer like this, position the mouse pointer like this on the tool and see the tool tip. So what was appearing when we are placing this mouse pointer over any icon, no? It was showing one tooltip, yes, no? One small rectangle, it is text is displayed, that is only known as tooltip. Next is cursor movement. So we have like this cursor will be appearing. See, one cursor is blinking now here, black color cursor. So if you want to move this cursor, you can use this arrow keys, right arrow, left arrow, all those keys you can use after typing. See, after typing, no? If you place the cursor here, I'm using left arrow key. If you want to move right side, you can use right arrow key. If you have some more contents down also, so if you want to move to up, you can use up arrow, and if you want to move down, you can use the down arrow. Okay, so like that, four arrow keys, that is known as cursor control keys. Okay, all these keys you can use. The text cursor is a flashing vertical line. See here, it is flashed only, no, it is flashing. Okay, it is blinking here. So blinking or flashing vertical line in the body of the text. The four arrow keys, that is left, top, down and the right on the keyboard, are called as cursor control or arrow keys, you will say. So text cursor movement, observe the location of the text cursor. So you need to observe where the text cursor is, which is the location of the text cursor, whether it is placed in the middle of the text or in the beginning or at the end, like that you need to check the location or observe the location. Press the different cursor control keys on the keyboard and watch how the text cursor moves around. That you can try it as a practical way. And next, there are two keys above the cursor control keys marked as home and end. Okay, above the cursor control keys, we will have the home key and end key. If you press the home key, it jumps to the beginning of the line. When you press the end key, it jumps to the end of the line. So the next is position the text cursor on the line of the document. Press the home key and observe the text cursor jumps to the beginning of the line. If you press the end key, observe the text cursor jumps to the end of the line. When these keys are pressed in the combination with control key, the cursor jumps to the beginning and you press control plus home. See here, they have done one mistake. This is not end key, this is home key. Okay, so when you press control plus home, it will be moving to the beginning of the document. If you use control plus end, it will go to the end of the document. Okay, not to the end of the line. Okay, end of the document. If you press just home key, end of the in the beginning of the line. If you just press end key, it will go to the end of the line. Okay, next one is mouse pointer. This is the mouse pointer. See this arrow only, no? That is known as mouse pointer. It takes the pointer shape while moving it around the screen. So when it is moved around the screen, it will be taking this pointer shape. When the mouse pointer changes to eye shape, when moved over the text in a document. See, now I am moving the cursor only over the text. See here, I am moving the cursor over the text. it was showing what? Eye shape. Okay, so the mouse pointer is changing to eye shape, and the, when we are moving over the text in a document, it will be taking this arrow shape when it is moved around on the screen. See, around the screen if you are moving, it will be showing in a what, in which shape? Arrow shape. But when you go to text part, it is changed as what? It is changed as eye shape. Okay. So next one, editing the document. Okay. So in order to do undo and redo options, no, we can go for this control Z also. For undo and for redo, control plus Y we need to use. Okay. Open the existing file. For example, report.odt, and then start editing in it. If by mistake you have made some changes, by mistake you have done some mistakes, no changes, no. Now you want to erase the last change done, then you need to use the undo option. And after undo command, again if you want to go back, then we need to use the redo option. So in order to go to undo and redo, you need to click on edit undo and edit redo. Okay, then moving and copying the text, cut and paste. Moving means to other location, and copying text also we will see here. So cut and paste we will see first. It is used to move a selected text from one place to another place. So you need to see the word clearly here, selected text. Before you move the text, you need to select the text. So cut and paste is used to move the selected text from one place to another. Okay, so select the text and click on edit cut option, or press control plus X. Okay, so we need to select the text and we need to click on edit cut or control plus X. We need to place the cursor where the text has to be moved. Click on edit paste and then, or then press control plus B. Okay, so after cutting the text, you want to place the text into some other location. For that you need to use control plus B, or you need to click on file, edit and paste. Okay, and then copy and paste. If you want to do copy and paste, it is used to make the duplicate copy of the selected text. So the same copy of the text will be available in the other place also. So for that, what you need to do, select the text and click on edit copy option, or press control plus C. Okay, and step two is place the cursor where the text has to be duplicated. So where you want to get the same copy of the document or as text, no, you need to click on edit paste option or press control B. Next is selecting the text. It is necessary to select the text to perform copy and paste operation. So the selected text will be highlighted. See here, like this, if you are selecting the text, it is highlighted in blue color, no? In the same manner, that selected text will be highlighted. For editing the text, you must first select the required text. Then the editing can be done on the selected text. Next, we will see selection criteria. To select the text in the writer, swipe the mouse cursor over the text. Okay, you need to swipe the mouse cursor over the text in order to select it. There are several selection tricks to speed up the selection process as below. So we need to go for several selection tricks in order to speed up our selection process. To select a letter or letters, to select a single word at a time, position the mouse pointer anywhere on that word and double click. So you need to position the mouse pointer anywhere on that, anywhere, single word if you want to select, okay, at a time. So you, where you can place anywhere on that word and double click on it, it will get selected. To select a complete sentence at a time, so complete sentence like this, if you want to select complete sentence, no, position the mouse pointer anywhere in the sentence and triple click on it three times continuous click. Okay, see here, three times continuous click if you do, it will get selected. Four times if you do the whole document. Okay, complete paragraph at a time, mouse pointer anywhere in the, and quadruple click. That is, quadruple means click, means to quickly click the left mouse button four times. I have clicked it, and three times if you click, sentence will get selected. That one line will get selected for three times. Four times means the entire paragraph. Okay, complete paragraph, the whole document. If you want to select, what you need to do, press control plus A on the keyboard, drag the mouse pointer till you see a right arrow which is white. Okay, then click it twice. So next we will see the next topics in our next class. So until then, you just go through this videos whatever we have covered till now, and be ready for your test. Thank you, children. Thank you.